गुड आफ्टरनून फ्रेंड्स, हाउ यू ऑल। टुडे वी विल बी स्टार्टिंग विद द यस, वी आर गोइंग टू हैव द सेशन मानसी ऑन एनालिटिकल रीजनिंग। इन फैक्ट टुडे इज माय फिफ्थ सेशन ऑन एनालिटिकल रीजनिंग, राइट? सो वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट विद दैट। टुडे इज गोइंग टू बी द लास्ट सेशन ऑन एनालिटिकल रीजनिंग as far as the set of LSAT are concerned, right? So once again a very good afternoon, right? And friends, as I said that today is the last session on analytical reasoning. If you are looking forward to any specific topic to be taken care of after this, then you please mention, so that if feasible I will take that as the next topic. Okay friends, so are we all ready for the session? Say yes. Hello Ankur, yes, if you are looking forward to some specific topic after this analytical reasoning session, right, then please let me know that as well, so that if feasible, right, I will be taking the topic on that. And I always see that few students right in the beginning itself, before the session starts, you like the session. I get the likes as well in the beginning itself, huh? Fine. So let's quickly start the session now. Right. So this is the set in front of you, right? Yes, I know. Okay, LSAT. Vaishnavi, how was it? SLAT was there yesterday. All right, let's focus on the session now. Fine, so this is a set of instruction given to you, right? During a 7-year period, an amusement park builds exactly 7 roller coasters. Then these are the conditions given. No two roller coasters are built in the same year, and each roller coaster is either steel or wooden. The following condition must apply, right? So yes, let's directly, this is not a timed test, right? So give me the answer to question number 69. Question number 69. Yes, what is the answer to question number 69? Take your time, because this is the very first slide. So take your time in putting all the datas, because then next session on, sorry, next slide onwards, you will not consume this much of time. Zafar, please put this message in private, and on which email you are asking me to check. Yes, question number 69. So the pretzel is built in the second year. So we know that there are the 7 years, right? So say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, and 7, right? Then P is built in the second year. Okay, fine. The roller coaster built in the first year is steel. Okay, so this has to be of steel. And the one built in the seventh year is wooden. Okay, the one built in the seventh year is wooden. Lasso is built after firecracker. So the condition has to be of. Okay, and I am putting the dots because it is not mentioned immediate. Okay, the lasso is built after firecracker, but it has nowhere mentioned immediate. Okay, so this is the rule. Okay. You can't see the complete slide. Wait a minute. Now, can you all see this complete slide? Yeah, a lot of instructions are there on this slide, so maybe yes, now it is visible, right? Okay, fine. So then we will have the session in this way only for this set. All right, fine. So what is the answer to question number 69? Right, so what we know is that it is wood. Okay, so this is what I was telling. Fine, so this is the condition that after wood, you know, this is the rule that after this firecracker, lasso will be built. The jackbread and gobbler are built before the hurricane, right? They are built before the hurricane. So then jackbread and gobbler, and then comes the hurricane. Okay, fine. Then exactly two of the roller coasters are built after the hurricane are steel. Exactly two of the roller coasters built after the hurricane are steel. Okay, fine. So after hurricane there has to be two steel, all right, and wooden roller coasters are not built in any two consecutive years. So see, dear friends, this is the condition given for the wood, that wooden roller coasters are not built in any two consecutive years, and from here we don't have to assume that the it is applicable for the steel as well. Okay, so let's see what are the maximum things we can fill in over here. Right, so let's see about this. So P is there, and after hurricane there should be only two steel and no two wood. So obviously one steel is going to be here, that is for sure. And wherever the hurricane comes, right, okay, before that J and G should be there. Okay, fine. So let's see. So I need two steels. So then hurricane, if I put it over here, then I'm going to get two steels, right? And because I can't go beyond this, the reason is, okay, let me put the numbers. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Okay, see, I can't go beyond, I can't put hurricane on the fifth position because I won't get two steels. And I can't put a hurricane on the third position because in that case, I need two blank, you know, places where I will be putting J and G. So from this, right, the condition I'm getting over here is either J would be here, then G would be here, or if G is here, right, then J will be here. So this is what is the max, you know, the condition I can, you know, the fulfill so far. Okay, fine. So this is what is there, and after F, so after F only the lasso would be there. It also means that F cannot be in the last position because after F only L. So what we have done, friends, we have put enough time in understanding all the conditions, right? Now let's see what is the answer to question number 69. Fine. So if I see question number 69, A cannot be the answer, right? Why A cannot be the answer? 69 elimination, let's go for the elimination. Why it cannot be the answer? Because let's say that P should be in the second position, right? We have one condition, P should be in the second position. So over here P is not in the second position, hence A will not be the answer, right? Then what about B? Why B will not be the answer? Because lasso is before firecracker. Because lasso is before firecracker. So B will not be the answer. C is okay. C, many of you have given the answer as C. Let's say D. where is the problem? D, Niagara can never come in the first position, right? As per this condition, so D and E both goes out of the picture, and hence the answer is going to be option C. But on this slide, what we have done is we have tried to put the maximum, you know, the conditions. Fine. So friends, in your notebook, just mention the basic conditions. Now I am changing the slide. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 70. What is the answer to question number 70? Which one of the following roller coaster must be steel? Must be steel. Right. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Here comes P, here comes W, here comes S, here comes H, here comes J and G and G and J. Right. So this is, I think, I have done. Right. What would be the answer? Yes, F. Because we know that whether F is here, L can be anywhere, or at the max F can be here. F can never come into the last position. The answer is A. Very good, friends. Very good. Oh, Samayak is here. Huh? Samayak, you are really giving a tough time to the students. Good. But such kind of competition is must. There are 16 students who are watching and only 2 or 3 of them are participating. May I know the reason behind it? Friends, may I know the reason behind it? See, here the answer, only the answer doesn't matter. Okay, friends, if you just participate and after that you analyze it, even if you learn when you do the things wrong. So that in future you don't repeat your answers, right, in the similar context, in the sense that you did something wrong, you will next time when you will be doing it, you will remember that these are the conditions where I had goofed up, I have to be very careful, and that is why I say, friends, you write. Okay, Mansi, Charmi, Devashri, Vaishnavi, please give me the answer. Okay, by the time they are giving me the answer, let's move on to the next question. Question number 71. Question number 71. What is the answer to question number 71? If the firecracker is built in the year immediately after a year in which a wooden roller coaster is built, then which one of the following must be true? Here be very careful, must be true. Okay, so let's see 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, right? And then here it is P, here it is W, here it is J or G, here it is G or J, and here comes hurricane, here comes steel. Okay, fine. So this is what we know. Right, so what is the answer? Wooden roller coasters are not built into any two consecutive. So why 71? The answer is B. Very good, Nishu Chaudhary. New names I can see over here. Very good, Bodu Harshit Sai. How come you know even 73, 74? I mean, it's fine if you have solved the set, it's okay. Please don't, distract the other people. The hurricane is wooden. Why so? You gave me the reason. I want to know the reason, friends, why the answer to 71 is B. You all are correct. Yes, answer, the gobbler is wooden, not necessary. But why hurricane is wooden? Because it is must be true, na? Give me the reason. Right, wooden is not built in consecutive years. Because F is not required to be immediate before L. Right. Okay. I'm not still convinced with your answer. See, if I give you such answer, will you accept it? I simply say that and P is not in the option. Yes, see, if I put it wooden, right, then over here, then steel, because two woodens cannot be in a sequence. Okay, I think some streaming issue is there. Fine, because some issue is there. Fine, okay, let's move forward because I'm getting your answers too late. 72. 72. Each of the following roller coaster must be built before the lasso, except yes, correct. Except yes, Niagara is the correct answer. Rest all can be. And 73. 73. If the jackbread and hurricane and the firecracker are built in 3 consecutive years, okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, and then we know. Right, and if the J, H, and F, J, H, and F are built in 3 consecutive years, in that we knew that then J would be here, G would be here, F would be here, L can be anywhere, right, in 3 consecutive years in that order, then each of the following must be true except I want to see the false one, right, for the false one, okay. Must be true except. So the firecracker is built before Niagara. Yes, it is feasible, right? Either L, I can have it over here, the two options, right? Either L or fine. So any of the two comes. So yes, it is feasible. The G is built before the. Yes, even this is also true. Hurricane is built before N. Yeah, even this is true. Niagara is built before Lasso. Yes, it is possible if I take this as a sequence. So it is possible. So we wanted to have the false one, and hence the Niagara is built before. Why, Nishru Chaudhary? Why answer would be D, dear? Which of the following must be true except the Niagara is built before? So 70, the pretzel is built before the jackbread. Yes, even this is true. So where is the problem in D? Where is the problem? Must be true except, right? See, 73, don't go. See, don't get carried away with the explanation which I am giving. I'm actually with your mind. I'm just saying yes, and you people are you are with me. No. Yes, Samay, correct, because must be true except. So when we see that, then it could be the case will not be there. Yes, rest of them are perfectly true, and in option D it is one of the possibilities, right? And that is why the answer is going to be D. answer is going to be D, because we don't want the possibility. Okay, very good. Let's move on to the next set, 74 to 77. Yes, L can come before, so can, then it was must, category was must. Fine, let's move on to the next set now, 74 to 77. So one thing I am observing is that when I keep a time test, right, the participants decrease drastically, but when I am doing a one-on-one question, right, the participants are there. Why so? Ultimately, we are not here just to solve the questions. We should do it in a time frame. Alright. So, on Tuesday evenings, the community center offers one session of each of the following six introductory classes. So, it is G and J. I'm not writing all this thing. I'm having very less space. So, gymnastics, jazz, dance, kung fu, meditation, tennis, yoga. No other introductory classes are offered on Tuesday. Each class is scheduled for exactly 1 hour, beginning at 5, 6, 7 and 8. Okay. And then we have the conditions. Yoga begins later than jazz, but not later than kung fu. It means what? So, after jazz, so if I talk about the rule number one says that yoga should be after jazz, but not later than kung fu. It means that either it is going to be yoga and kung fu, or it can be yoga and it can be taken simultaneously, but not later than that, right? So, this is what is the interpretation of the rule number one. Meditation begins at the same time as exactly one introductory class. So, rule number two says that meditation, and along with that, there has to be some other class as well. Only meditation will not be there. Rule number three, what does the rule number three says? That no other introductory class begins at the same time as gymnastics. So, it means then when gymnastic is happening, only gymnastic, no other class with that, and at most one of the other introductory classes begins later than gymnastic. So, after gymnastic, rule number 4 says that after gymnastic, right, at most one, that is at most one will be either gymnastic would be last, or only one will be there after gymnastic. Okay, so these are the basic rules. Now let's come with the questions. Since the rules are very clear, let's say question number 74. What is the answer I am getting? Oh, there are two people and both are giving different answers. Question number 74. Let's say A can be the answer, right? No, because after gymnastic there are two, you know, sessions are there. So, A goes out of the picture. What about option B? Right, option B, whenever the gymnastic is happening, only gymnastic should be there, and hence this goes out of the picture. Then C, jazz and meditation, and after jazz yoga is there, kung fu, tennis and gymnastic, either only, yes, it is taking care of all the conditions. So, either I should mark C directly over here, or else you can eliminate option D and E. Option D says, what does the option D says? Meditation alone, right? So, this is not possible. Along with meditation, there should be some other, there should be some other class. So, this goes out of the picture. And what about option E? Yoga and jazz, right? The sequence have been interchanged. So, answer is C. Right. So, here it is all about, accuracy as well. See friends, almost 70 questions we have done so far. After doing these many questions, it is expected that now along with the accuracy, right, along with the speed, even accuracy has to be maintained. So make it a, because say when there are 23 questions in a set of LSAT, if I specifically talk about, out of 4, generally 3 are manageable, but if you can do even 1 or 2 questions and make it 20 or 21 plus, you would be into a 99 percentile, right? So that is why be very careful. Anyways, question number, so we are very clear with the rules now, right? So let's go to the question number 75. Yes, Educational Mishra ji, focus on the question now. Harshit Sai, are you really doing it along with us, or you have already solved this set earlier? Please answer. If meditation is to begin later than 10 a.m, then which of the following could be true of the schedule? Could be true. Zazz begins later than meditation. Oh, superb. Zazz dance begins later than meditation, because we have to see could be true, right? So we have to just see that. So if I put at 5 p.m., 6 p.m., 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. So if I'm going with option A, right? If I'm putting Zazz, then what will happen? So Zazz dance begins later than meditation. So if I put meditation, there has to be one introductory class over here. Then if I put Zazz, right, then if I put yoga and kung fu, and then I put gymnastic. What is wrong? Oh, Zazz begins later than meditation. Okay. So if I put Zazz over here, meditation over here, and with that I put tennis. So any rule I am violating over here in question number 75? Yes, I know. Yes, correct. The answer is kung fu begins later than gymnastics. Fine. See, in this setup, which rule I have violated? Why? Answer, Zazz dance begins later than meditation. Okay, even if I put it over here, meditation, and then I put tennis, and then I put Zazz, and then I put, or even I can, yeah, yoga and kung fu together, and I put gym. So where is wrong? Zazz should at 6 p.m. Why so? Yeah, that is what the answer I want to know, na? Why so? Five p.m., 6 p.m., 7 p.m. and 8 p.m. Which rule is getting violated? Yes, am I audible to everyone? Yeah, some bit of technical errors here. So, anyways, fine. Right, so the Kung Fu begins later than gymnastic. Why is it so? Educational Mishra, even I know all the answers, friend. I have to put such questions so that I want to see how many of you are giving me the convincing answer. Would you enjoy the session if I just simply write the answer and I just move on? Alright. So, Zaz cannot begin, right, later than this meditation. This is a problem because here we want the could be true and Kung Fu begins later than gymnastic. That is one of the possibilities are there, right? So, fine. Question number 76. Yes, meditation. Exactly. Yeah, that is what is answer. Meditation has to be after tennis. Fine. Chale, let's move on to the next question. Question number 76. Which of the following introductory class could be the only class scheduled to begin at 5 p.m. Right? We are starting at 5, 6, 7, 8. Right? So, the answer is question number 76. Yes, we can't start yoga. So, first option is not the answer, and introductory classes could be is there, and I can start with the tennis, right? So, the answer is going to be B. Okay. So, the answer is B. See, and why the answer, you know, the C cannot be there, because could be the only class, okay, only class. I can't at first position, I can't put meditation, because along with meditation, there has to be one more session, and hence I cannot have C, right? Same is the case also, and gymnastic definitely cannot come at 5 o'clock, because after that, there has to be only one session. So, gymnastic goes out of the picture. If I talk about Kung Fu, what is the problem in Kung Fu? Y and K. But before that, J has to be there. So, even that option is not there. Okay. So, clear? Fine. Hetal, I'll come down to question number 75. 77. Right? Fine. Which of the following introductory classes cannot be scheduled at 6 p.m.? Cannot be scheduled at 6 p.m. So, it's very simple. Straight answer is there. Very straight answer. The answer is going to be yes, correct. Cannot be scheduled at 6 p.m. Right? So, A. Fine. Very good. See, for question number 75, right, after tennis, meditation would be coming, and then we have to consider that condition of this Zaz and this. So, that is the reason that option A cannot be there. Answer will be option 5. I'm sorry. Question number 75, the answer will be B. Let's move on to the next topic. Next set, question number 78 to 82. Be ready. There's a new set. Each of the five experts are there. A lawyer, a naturalist, oceanographer, P and S individually, exactly one of the presentation at a conference. The five presentations are given consecutively. Each presentation is in exactly one of the four following languages, right? And so how many presentations are there? Five presentations, and there are four languages. So obviously one of the languages is going to get repeated. Fine. Then The conditions, exactly two of the presentations are in the same language. Okay, statistician gives the second presentation in Hindi. All right, so say 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So second presentation stats is there, which is going to be in Hindi. So this is what is there. This is my rule number 2. Rule number 3, lawyer gives the fourth presentation either in Mandarin or French. So here comes the lawyer who gives either in French or Mandarin language. The oceanographer presents either in French or Japanese, and same is true for physicist. Okay, so oceanographer can give the presentation either in French or Japanese, and same is the case with physicist. Okay, so French or Japanese. The first person presentation and the last, the first presentation and the last presentations are in Japanese. Okay, so the first is in Japanese and the last is in Japanese. Fine. All right. So now comes the question, which one of the following could be the order, could be the order in which the experts give their presentation from first to last, right? So we we know that the answer, right, to get the answer either we go elimination. So here we know that at the fourth position lawyer should be there. Now let's see how many cases. So in first 1, 3, so lawyer here it is at the third position, so A cannot be the answer, and same is a case here, C cannot be the answer. So now we are left with B and D. Okay, fine. So what about B? Wait a minute, sorry, 1, 2, 1, oceanographer, second, third, fourth, I'm sorry. Here D will not be the answer because here it is at the third position. So now I have to identify the answer between B and C, right? And physicist, naturalist, oceanographer, the lawyer and the statistician. So where is the problem between B and C? Statistician should be at the second position. So this is not the answer, right? And hence the answer is going to be C. Question number 78, the answer is C. Ankur, I goofed up with option C and D. Okay, so because of that, right, the lawyer's position should be at the fourth position. So while reading I made the mistake. Okay, so clear. Question number 78. Let's move on to the next question. Question number 79. Which of the following is a complete and accurate list of the experts and any one of whom could be one of the two present in Japanese? Who present in Japanese? Question number 79. So we know who all cannot be. 1, 2, 3, 4. So here comes stats that has been given in Hindi. Lawyer at fourth position, right? Mandarin or French or French or Mandarin, first and last. Right, so which one of the following is a complete and accurate list of experts, any one of whom could be one of the two who presents in Japanese? Question number 79. What is the answer? Question number 79. The oceanographer and the physicist. Okay, so then we know that oceanographer can give in French or Japanese, and even physicist gives French or Japanese, right? So if I say that the oceanographer, one of the two who presents is in Japanese. So if I put over here, right? Okay. So then, and the physicist. If I put, so is it feasible? Can I put physicist over here? No. Right, because oceanographer cannot give the presentation in Japanese, so this cannot be the answer. And which of the following could be? Yes, the naturalist, the oceanographer, and the physicist. So if I go with that, the answer is yes, it is possible. Because here, if I take one, you'll have to go with the elimination. One will automatically come to the other. So the answer is B. Moving on to the next question, number 80. Dear, you focus on the question. It is could be. It is not must. Samay, that's why. So we are taking all possibilities. We are considering here all the possibilities. Question number 80. If the natural is present in French, okay, so 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now the natural is present in French. So obviously N comes over here. So this goes out. It means that the lawyer gives in Mandarin language. Which one of the following could be true? Question number 80. Question number 80. The oceanographer gives the third presentation? No. So that goes out. The oceanographer presents fifth? Yes, it is possible. It is possible, right? So here it is could be true and this is possible. So I am putting the answer as B. I am not checking for rest of the options. Okay. This is basically O and P or P and O. This is the option which I was left with. Very good. Question number 80. The answer is B. 81. 81. So which one of the following is a complete and accurate list of the languages, any one of which could be the language of the third presentation? Third presentation. Very simple. We know for the third presentation, yes, straight question 81D. Very good. Now we are coming down to question number 82. Question number 82. Suppose the condition that the statistician gives the second presentation in Hindi is replaced with the condition that the statistician gives either of the presentation given in Japanese. Okay. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So rest of the conditions are as it is. And here was Hindi. Right. And if all the other conditions remain in effect, which one of the following could be the order from the first to last in which the experts present? So either statistician should be in the first position in case 1, and in case 2 the statistician should be either in the last position. So if the statistician is in the first position, I consider that, so then obviously my option, okay, let's see. So if I see that option D is there, right? So statistician is there. Then comes the oceanographer, then comes naturalist, the lawyer and the physicist. Okay, so someone is giving me the answer as A, the naturalist, because I am taking statistician last. Let's say if I put over here naturalist, then comes the oceanographer, then comes physicist. Okay. Then comes lawyer and then statistician. What about the language part? Japanese, Hindi, Mandarin, French and Mandarin and Japanese. So which is the rule getting violated over here? 82. May A may which is the rule getting violated over here? Yes, which is the rule getting violated over here? A is not the answer. O is not in Hindi. Why no? It can be. Acha. Oceanographer was giving either French or Japanese. Yes. So, O I cannot write for Hindi. Correct. Right. Same was a for the physicist. We have to apply even in D, O will be Hindi. So, then what we are going to do? Okay, fine. Let's say option B cannot be the answer because it is coming at the second position. Chali, this goes out. The physicist, the oceanographer, the lawyer. Here, obviously, because lawyer is coming into the third position, even this goes out. So now it is a fight between A and D. What will be the answer? Which of one of the following could be the order? Friends, we are missing this word. Could be the order. Fine. So let's say if I take oceanographer in both and the second position. Ankur, then why not A? Because if I take that as a reason that oceanographer not Hindi, so even in this position, this thing also, A also the here Hindi is coming. There is some other reason as well. Give me that reason because of which we can eliminate. What about Mandarin and French? Mandarin and French. Yes. Because here, I think then there is some typo error. Let's leave this question because I think there is some error over here while typing the answer. Let's drop the question number 82. Let's not waste time on this because yes, in both the cases, the same reason is coming up. Okay. Fine. Next set 83 to 87. So, Shanti interviews exactly 5 out of a total 7 job applicants. So she interviews the 5 one at a time. One each interviewing must meet the following condition. Lata is interviewed at second or third. Okay. So, 1, 2, 3, 4. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, either Lata is interviewed at second position or Lata is interviewed at the third position. Okay. Nasir or Tarun is interviewed last. Okay. Nasir or Tarun are interviewed last. Gopi, if interviewed, is interviewed first. Okay. So, if Gopi is there, then she has to be at the first position. This is, say, my rule number 3. Irfan is interviewed immediately after Rohit if both are interviewed. So, it has to be like Rohit and Irfan. Okay, this is my rule number 4. Rule number 5 says that Oscar is interviewed immediately after Rohit if both are interviewed. Okay, so now you can see that after Rohit, either there will be only Irfan or Oscar. Both cannot be because both are immediately after Rohit. And Tarun is interviewed immediately after Nasir if both are interviewed. Okay, fine. Tarun is interviewed immediately after Nasir if both are interviewed. Okay, so in that case, if N and T is there, and then in that case T is going to be last. Yes, don't be sorry about it. Okay, I know. I mean, because since last 5 days I'm taking this this law analytical reasoning, and it's not that easy. After 2 or 3 sets, it's not that easy to continue with it, and students later on, they do watch it. Fine, so let's focus on it, and thank you so much for your concern. Okay, fine. So question number 83, which one of the following could be a complete and accurate list of the applicants interviewed listed in the order in which they are interviewed? So C definitely cannot be the answer, because very immediate it was that Gopi cannot be in the second position, right? So C goes out of the picture, right? And let's see if I go with the option Gopi, Lata, Irfan, Nasir and Tarun. Yes, so and in which they are, so the answer is A, right? B cannot be the answer because Lata is in the fourth position and Oscar and Rohit, here the sequence has been interchanged. The answer is A. Question number 83, the answer is A. 84. Which one of the following is a complete and accurate list of the applicants, each of whom must be interviewed? Must be interviewed. So, see, because, okay, let me see what is your answer. 84. Question number 84. Very simple, very straight. Correct. 84, not D, Devashree, not D, because it is must be interviewed. Okay. So, we know that Lata, either she would be in second position or third position. So, Lata must be there. Gopi, if interviewed, she will be in the first position. If interviewed, it doesn't mean must be interviewed, right? Because 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, I can drop Gopi and still I can have the answer. So, if I drop Gopi and still if I can have the answer is going to be B. Okay? Because it is must be interviewed. Question number 85. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. So, if Irfan is interviewed fourth, if Irfan is interviewed fourth, it means that what must be true, must be true. Eighty-five. The answer is C. Rohit is interviewed. Must be. Can't we drop it? Say if I take. All right. Say I have Gopi, Irfan, Lata, Nasir, Oscar, Rohit, and Tarun. Okay. Fine. And Irfan is there. See, if Rohit and Irfan are interviewed, then it is going to be R and I. Let's put Tarun, because if I put Nasir and Tarun both together, but then they should, but that is no way possible. Nasir cannot be there, so let me put that as Tarun over there. Then I had a condition of R and I, but if I am not taking R, right, I can take O over here, I can put Lata over here, and I can put Gopi over here. Right, that is feasible. You people are saying C, Rohit is interviewed, but see, it is not must be. Even if I take must be, okay, so this, in this case Rohit goes out of the picture. Okay, so but if I take Rohit and this and that, Lata has to be either at second or third position. So here obviously Lata would be at second position, and Gopi, because I cannot take any other. Can I take instead of G any other person? Let's do that. See, L, R, I and T have been taken care of. L for the case 2. Can I take anyone else? Nasir is interviewed last. No, Samayak. Because see, what is the last rule? Tarun is interviewed immediately after Nasir if both are interviewed. So D goes out of the picture. If only one out of Nasir and Tarun, right? So D is not the answer. Then can I replace over here anyone else? Hetal, if I am putting Nasir, then Nasir and Tarun have to be together. Samay, you again read the condition. You are goofing up with the condition. See, Tarun is interviewed immediately after Nasir if both are interviewed. So it is going to be NT. NT. And here, or else it would be only T. So Nasir, Khalil, again I am giving the same explanation. T cannot, T will be only in case, see, out of Nasir and Tarun, only one of them could be last. Since Irfan is at the fourth position, then it will be only Tarun, not Nasir. You see the last condition. So because of that, the order is NT, or else it is going to be only T. Fine, so this cannot be the answer. Now my only question was that can I replace anyone over here in this circle except Gopi? Try to do this. See, Gopi, Irfan, Lata, Nasir, Oscar, Rohit and Tarun. So Tarun I have already, Tarun had to be there. Then Irfan had to be there. Right? I am taking in one case Rohit also. Right? And Lata. Now if I don't take Gopi, if I don't take Gopi, can I put N over there? No. I can't put in first position N, because in that case N and T has to be there. I can't put O, because if I put O, then R and O has to be there. R and O has to be there. So answer is Gopi is interviewed. That is must be true. If the order is G L R L T, yes, Amayak. That is what the answer is. Devashri, what is your concern, beta? If the order is G L R L T, G L G L R, fine. Devashri, you are goofing up. We don't have to find the possibility. This must be true. So even in your case also, Gopi is coming. In another case, Rohit is coming, right? So that goes out of the picture. The answer is Gopi must be. So you take all possibilities. Gopi is always going to be there. That is what is the thing. Okay. Question number 86. If Gopi is interviewed first, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. If Gopi is interviewed first and Oscar is interviewed second, so then Lata has to be at the third position. Then each of the following could be true except, so we want to find the false one. Right, so we want to find the false one. Irfan is interviewed fourth. Yes, it is possible. I can take Irfan over here, no problem. Rohit is interviewed fourth. See, if Oscar is at second position, can I take Rohit over here? Rohit is no way possible. Right, so the answer is B. Here it is negative. Who said 6? C. Samayak, have some water, dear. See, what is the question? The question is which of the following could be true except, so the option should not be true. We have to find the false one. So Rohit is interviewed fourth. That is no way possible. So answer is 87. Even Nasir cannot be. Okay. I'll come back to that question. Do question 87. Actually, Nasir can be interviewed last year. If out of Nasir and Tarun, only one person is getting interviewed, then that person can be last. So, possibility is there that Nasir is last. Question number 87. Suppose the condition that Nasir or Tarun is interviewed last is replaced with the condition that neither Nasir nor Tarun is interviewed last. Okay. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Fine. If all the initial conditions remain in effect, then which of the following must be true if Rohit is interviewed last? So Rohit is here. So if Rohit is here, then either Lata will be at this position or I can put Lata at this position. No, sorry. Lata would be at the second position. But if Nasir and Tarun are interviewed, I need two positions together, right? So in that case, it should be Gopi, Lata, Nasir and Tarun. This is the only possibility I have it. This goes out of the picture. Okay. So then what will be the answer to question number 87? Question number 87. Tarun is interviewed fourth. Exactly, one of Irfan and Oscar is interviewed. Irfan must be true. Isme to Irfan and no one is here. Exactly, one of Nasir and Tarun is interviewed. No, both are there. Irfan is interviewed fourth. No, Tarun was interviewed fourth. So the answer is D. 87, the answer is D. Okay. Fine. So we'll have one time test today. Okay. So be prepared. Are we all ready? It can be just a moment. Ankur, if Nasir and Tarun both are interviewed, then they will be following this order only. Last condition. Okay. So fine friends, let's ready be. Today I just brought one, you know, the time test. So let's start with this. All right, friends. So a very easy set. Agreed? Very easy set. Okay, let's see. So first of all, an industrial electrician exactly attaches seven components designated as this to a circuit board in exactly seven consecutive steps. Each component is attached per step. Each component is attached exactly once, and each is attached either by hand or by machine, but not both. Okay, so X is the fourth. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So X is the fourth component. Exactly two components are attached by hand at some time before X. So before X, right, there has to be 2H. Okay. Then no component is attached by hand before T. Okay, fine. So, all right. W is attached at some time before T. Okay. So, W, and then comes T. Y is attached at some time after both Z and S. So, Z, S, and after that Y should come. The sixth component attached is by hand. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So this one is attached by hand. All right. Now, so X is the fourth and exactly two components attached by hand at some time before X. So there has to be two. So can I put, and W and T should also be there. So obviously W comes here, T comes here, and then I will be having, right, two hands. Okay, and exactly only two hands are there before that. So this has to be machine. W has to be attached by machine. Okay, so these are the only things which I know for sure. Rest all, I don't know. Okay, so let's start with question number 88. So, which one of the following could be an accurate list in order of the first three components? So, W and T, and the moment I mentioned W and T, the answer comes over here as A, because in no other option is W and T, because for sure W and T has to be there in first and second position. Okay. Next question, question number 89. Which of the following component must be attached by machine? Let's go to question number 80. Must be attached by machine. So here I can see that W is there. Fine. So the answer is going to be B. 89 B. Question number 90. If V is the seventh component, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, V is the X is fourth, W is here, T is here, hand, and here comes machine, and here comes hand. Okay, fine. So if V is the seventh component attached, each of the following component could be attached by the machine except each of the following components could be attached by machine. Okay, so can I put S? Yes, what is the answer? 90, the answer is right. If this is the seventh, right, so then X can be anything. right? X cannot be because there are only two hands. So here it comes machine. So the answer is C, not Y. There could be attached by machine. Could be attached by machine. So if I put over here Z or S or S or Z, I can. Okay, then in that case Y has to be there, right? So the answer is C. Yes. Y will never be machine, correct? So the answer is D. Question number 90, the answer is D. Question number 91. Which one of the following is a complete and accurate list of the components, any one of which could be the sixth component attached? 91. One, two, three, four, five, six. W and T. So, which of the following and complete accurate list of components, which could be the sixth component? Obviously, W cannot be there. So, this goes out. This goes out. Even T cannot be there. So, this goes out. So, the answer is C. 91. The answer is C. Be the sixth component. They are asking about the sixth component. Okay. So, I can have it, right? All right, fine. Z needs to. It can be anything, Devarshri. It can be anything. Z needs to come before X. Not necessary. I can even put it like this. S over here, Z over here. And then I can have it, you know, Y over here and V over here. I can do it. Even I can interchange these two. So fine. 91, the answer is C. 92. Which one of the following component must be attached by hand? Must be attached by hand. Ninety-two. So option A is the answer. Very good, because it is must be. So we don't have to check because it is universally true. And 93. If S is attached by machine, which one of the following must be true? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. W, T, X, hand. And we know that Z and S. So, yes, Z is attached by hand. Correct. So, easy set. We'll now go for the last set. For this analytical reasoning, 94 to 99, here you will be using the concept of the parallel deduction as well. Okay, let's not confuse it. Just answer only one thing. You have to type the answer. Okay, if I give you this condition, if A implies B, what are the other deductions I can make from this? What are the other deduction I can make from this statement? If A is there, B has to be there. From this, which other deduction I can make? Very good. If not B, yes. If B is not there, then A cannot be there. If you are comfortable with this concept, then only you will be in a position to solve this set. Solve question number 24. I'm sorry, 94. No, Devanshri, it is not necessary. If A is there, then B has to be there. But if B is there, then it is not necessary that A has to be there. It is a one-way condition. Okay. So, the rule number one says, Faisal presents, right? Then do Monica and Pooja. So Monica and Pooja will be there. Okay, so the presentation is given. So Darshan Advertising Agency is exactly 7 representatives are there, and its campaign is exactly one client by one or more of the representative. No condition how many. Okay, so it can be 1, 2, 3, 4, all. Then we end with the condition. So rule number one says that if Faisal presents, then do Monica and Pooja. So what is the reverse of it? I can also say that if Monica and Pooja are not representing, then Faisal cannot represent. This is what the interpretation is. Rule number two. John presents, then Kadir not. John presents, then Kadir not. It also means that if Kadir presents, sorry. If Kadir, because no cup, it will be positive, no positive. So it means that if Kadir presents, right, then in that case, it is going to be John cannot present. Only one of them. Okay. What does the rule number three says? Rule number three says that Kadir does not present, then Pooja does. Kadir does not present, then Pooja does. Or Pooja does not present, then Kadir does. So, out of Pooja and Kadir, at least one of them have, both are there, no problem. But at least one of them has to be there. It is a very important condition, friend. So, just keep into consideration this thing. Then, rule number four. What does the rule number four says? Lekha represents. If Lekha represents, then either John or Shobhit or both represent, right? Fine. So in only one case, if John is not there and Shobha is not there, then only Lekha will not be there. And the rule number five. What does the rule number 5 says? Both Lekha and Shobhit present. Lekha and Shobhit, if both are present, then Monica does not. Okay? It also means that if Monica presents, then they both are not present. Okay? Ready? Fine. So let's start with the question. Now see, if this understanding is clear now, then you can very easily, you know, bang on this set. Okay. So let's go ahead with it. Question number 94. What is the answer to question number 94? Can A be the answer? Can A be the answer? No. See, which one of the following could be a complete and accurate list of the representative who present? So, if I say Monica and Shobhit, but as I said that रूल नंबर थ्री, एज पर द रूल नंबर थ्री, either one of them has to be there, either Pooja or Kadir, and according to A, none of them is present, right? So these two cannot be the people giving the presentation. So A is not the answer, right? What about B, Faisal? If Faisal gives, then Monica and Pooja, so this is not there, so B cannot be the answer. Okay, what about C, Faisal, Lekha, Monica and Pooja, right? If Lekha is there, okay, if Lekha is there, then which is the point missing? Either rule number 4, you see the rule number 4 is not getting satisfied over here, that out if Lekha is there, then out of J and S, that is John and Shobhit, one of them has to be present and none of them is present over here, and hence the answer is D. So 94, the answer is D. Question number 95. If Lekha and Kadir both present, Lekha gives a presentation and Kadir gives a presentation. No, Ankur. See. All right. Here, in which all four are incorrect. See, Ankur, here in fourth, because A, B and C were for sure not the answer. So, here I have put C and Kadir, Pooja. So, in D, where you are finding it wrong, tell me. Any condition is getting violated over here? According to you, what I did, I eliminated option A. If M plus P, then F. No, the rule number 1 says that if Faisal is there, then only Monica and Pooja both will be present. You see how I have written? No, this is a wrong interpretation. Interchange it. If Faisal presents, then Monica and Pooja will be there. That is why I said that this parallel deduction is going to be if A, then B. This condition should be very clear. Okay? Fine. So, question number 95. Lekha and Kadir, they present, right? Then what is the question? Then which of the following could be true? Faisal presents. Can I say that Faisal presents? Question number 95. If L is there, then S and Q. Because if L is there, then out of Shobha or John, one has to be present. Okay, so this is there. So the answer is going to be that at least these many people are going to be there. So exactly 3 of the 7 people are there. Okay, so the answer is D, correct. Question number 96. Which one of the following representatives could be the only representative who presents? Only representative. Can Faisal be the only representative? No. If Faisal is there, then Monica and Pooja will be there. So, there will be the 3 representatives, right? So, A cannot be the answer, right? What about B? If John is there, then out of Pooja and Kadir, one has to be there, right? So, there will be at least 2 representatives, two representatives. So, B will not be the answer. And same is the case with Shobhit also. If Shobhit is there, then out of P and Q, one should be there. So, this also goes out of the picture. The answer is C. Question number 96, the answer is C. Anjani, D option will not be the answer here, because with Shobhit, as per the rule, there has to be one person out of P and Q. Okay, so D is not the answer. 97. Which one of the following cannot be true? Cannot be true. That is, Faisal and Kadir both present. This is possible. What is the answer to question number 97? Yes. Which one of the following cannot be true? So, Faisal and Kadir both represent. Why so? You know the condition? Very good. If exactly two of the presentatives present, then which one of the following representative cannot be the one of the two who presents? 98. If exactly two of the representatives are present, then which one of the following cannot be, right? It cannot be Lekha. Why? Because if I go as per the condition, right? If Lekha is there, then out of one, John or Shobhit has to be there. Fine. And then we need one person from P and Q as well. So, that person cannot be Lekha. Because if Lekha is there, then out of J and S, one person. And out of P and Q, there has to be one person. So, then there are exactly three people, right? So, the answer is A. Okay, and 99. If Faisal represents, then which one of the following must be true? Very simple. If Faisal is there, then Monica and Pooja makes a presentation. Okay, so at least three of the representatives, this is must be true. Very good. So with this, right? We are ending this marathon of analytical reasoning. Okay, friends. So, I hope you enjoyed. I knew it was a bit, heavy as well, taking so many sets at one time. But it was must. Right? So, please go through it once again with all the five sessions. So, start one of the topic, we can add it to our list, where we can now bang on any of the questions on analytical reasoning. All the best. Thank you very much.